Okay, so I will start the session, briefing session for Engineering Mechanics Lab 2. So students, welcome back to online learning. Unfortunately for semester 1, 2021, the classes for the labs and the laboratory work will be carried out online, virtually. We will be providing you either online sessions or we will be giving you videos, and your friends who did this lab in the previous semester will also give you the same experience that this is how we are going to be conducting the lab for this semester. So the first things are what we are going to go through are the topics that we will see today. So today I will tell you about the sections, what is the distribution of sections for this lab. The teaching plan, we are going to go through what we are going to learn for this semester. Then the assessment distribution, whether we have long report, short report, whether there is presentation or there is nothing like that. This is something that we will look into. Next, the mode of conduct, which is virtual. Group allocation, so your allocation or group allocation has been made as well. Attendance, how the attendance is going to be carried out. Reports briefing, in the reports briefing, I will tell you, okay, the mistakes that students make during making report, because for labs it's quite easy for you guys to secure A grade or A minus grade. It is quite easy. However, you have to follow certain guidelines, certain briefing guidelines that today I will be telling you. If you're going to follow those steps, then perhaps it will be very easier for you guys to get A or A minus. However, there are times when students miss those tips and tricks, and they miss those briefing guidelines, and that's when they lose marks. So this is something that I will discuss in the report briefing. Then we've got short reports, so we will be giving you a briefing on short reports. Practical, how the practical part of your work will be evaluated. And then the safety briefing will be carried out. So who are the instructors for this semester? For this semester, I am your coordinator as well as your lecturer for section M01. The lectures for M01 are Dr. Moin and Dr. Jameel. Dr. Jameel is also the instructor for this lab, and he will also help you out in conducting the lab in regards to technical instructor. So Dr. Jameel this time is carrying out the duties and responsibilities of a technical instructor. Dr. Ackerman for section 2, section 3 will be Dr. Siti Aisha, section 4 is Dr. Lukman, and section 5 is Mr. Ammar. And the lab instructor for the whole course is Mr. Muhammad Haleem bin Babu. So what is the teaching plan for this semester? For this semester, the teaching plan is that you've got three outcomes: CO number 1, CO number 2, and CO number 3. For CO number 1, you have to basically go into the material properties, including and not limited to tension, compression, torsion, fatigue, and bending moment, provided that you also go through shear force. Shear force as well. These are more or less related to static based test. So they come under the static testing, except for the fatigue and torsion. And the free fall kinematics, accelerating particles, principles, sorry, kinematics of rigid body are something which are in the dynamics part of your portion. Then course outcome number 2 is that you have to show skills in basically carrying out the lab work, basically assembling the tools and experiments. So this part will be evaluated by the JP. So perhaps maybe you will be given a project to carry out some practical by yourself. Okay. So perhaps we will give you the lab sheets, but maybe we will tell you, okay, try to simulate using home tools or using commonly available tools. So it will be the ability for you to how you use the tools commonly available and how do you implement them in your real life experiments. Last but not least, this is the most important thing which many people miss, which this is CO number 3. So because of the fact that groupings are done, and groupings are done not with students' input, grouping is done randomly in the ascending order. So you might not be a very good friend, or you might not be you might not know your group members very well. So this is a chance that you have to know your group member very well. You have to allocate responsibilities for each member. It's not that only the group leader is going to work. Okay, it is very, very important. We can see from the report whether this report has been done by one person or this report has been completed by a selected number of students. So CO number 3 is something we will use our experience to evaluate you that this report was written by one person or a collection of persons, and whether the input was from everybody or whether the input was from not everybody, only maybe the group leader or the one who is very good at writing reports. So it is very, very important at this stage that you guys make groups. The groups will be announced in this class, and after making the groups, it is important for you guys to divide the responsibilities of working within each other. So this is a challenge for you guys. So the assessment will be practical lab observation 20%. The technical instructor is going to basically evaluate this part. The quiz will be 30%. Okay, quiz is basically a short report. So in this lab, we will have two types of reports. Number one is long report. Long report is called laboratory report. Okay, long report is called laboratory report, and this is equals to 50%. And number two is short report. Short report is called quiz, and this is equal to 30%. So these are the distribution of your assessment for current semester. So what are the topics and what are the labs that you are going to carry for this semester? You have got briefing sessions. So week number one is the briefing session, which I'm going to give you guys. Then week number 2 to 4 are common properties of material, tensile and compression testing. So please, these weeks are not correct. I have a correct distribution of weeks, which I will give you in the next slides. So common properties of materials are present, tensile and compression testing, torsion and fatigue testing, shear force and bending moment, transformation of stress and strain, and free fall experiments, including inertia and rotation motion, and rolling disc on an inclined plane. So these are basically the kinematics part, and these are static and dynamic parts. So what are the total number of labs? Lab number one. So your labs will start from week number 3, okay? So remember, your labs will start from week number 3, starting from week number 3. And then we will have lab number 2, compression test, okay, which will be in week number 4, torsion test in week 5, fatigue test in week 6, shear force and bending moment in week 7, transformation of stress and strain in week 8, free fall test in week 9, inertia in rotational motion in week 10, rolling disc on inclined plane on week 11. So total of 9 labs will be carried out. Each lab will be carried out in each week, and your labs will finish in week number 11. So the assessment distribution, as I said earlier, the quiz is equivalent to short report, and we have got 5 short report labs. So this will be equal to 30%. We have got long reports. These are about 4 of them, and they will be equal to 50% weightage. And the practical will be given by JP about 1 to 4. It depends on the JP's. He will be the one who will inform you guys. And this is equivalent to 20%. So the types of reports have been distributed into long report and short report. So you can see the distribution of long report and short report here. These reports have been added to Kalam as well. If you can go to Kalam, you will see that the long report and short reports are also present. So your assessment have been distributed such that the long report is equal to 12.5% marks. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 labs. So you have got 4 long report labs. LR is equals to long report, and they are equal to 12.5 times 1, 2, 3, 4. This is equals to 50%. So you can see that long reports have a huge impact on the grade that you guys are going to achieve this semester. So make sure that you are very, very careful in long report. However, short reports, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Each report is 6 marks, so a total of 30% mark, and practical is 20%. So how the lab is going to be conducted? The lab is going to be conducted virtually. Okay. As per KP instructions, the labs will be carried out as per the timetable. And the lecturers will conduct the attendance for the respective section layer number 1 to layer number 9. And the lecturers are going to give you guys the data for the experiments that will be shared on Kalam as well. Group allocation. So the group allocation will be carried out based on the student list which is available in IMS, and then we are going to do an ascending order grouping, which means that the first 5 students will be in group 1, the next 5 students will be in group 2, and so on. So for my section, I have got 30 students. So I have got 30 students divided by 5 students, which will be equals to 6 groups for my section. So it is important that you guys should know what is your group number and what is your section. So here is the group distribution for section M01. Group A, B, C, D, E, N, F for group M01. Total number of students for each group are 5 each. So the attendance will be carried out. It is important for you guys to attend the lab. Okay, if there is any problem, if there is any emergency, if there is something which came up, then it is important that you should inform the lecturer or JP. You should record it on WhatsApp, and you should communicate him or her on WhatsApp what happened to you and why is the reason why you cannot join the lab. And if you have any proof as well, then that would be an added value. Report submission will be carried out by group. So it's not that one person will submit, every student has to submit the report. No, only a group has to submit a report. It is important for all students to follow the safety procedure. Although you cannot follow the safety procedure, however, it is important that you should have some idea and some knowledge of the safety procedures that should be followed when handling a lab. Okay, so whenever you are handling any lab, whenever you are handling equipment, tools, chemicals, then there are some safety procedures that should be followed, and this is something that you should know, and this is something that will count for your practical 20%. So the GP will evaluate this part of the 20% in terms of safety as well. So the submission will be done on Kalam. Okay. So how the short report and long report is going to be submitted? So the short report will be submitted on the same day before 12 o'clock midnight. Okay. And the long report will be submitted exactly 1 week after the lab is conducted. So before the lab starts, before the new lab starts, you have to submit the long report. Lab starts from week 3. So now I will start the report guidelines. Okay. For the long report, students have 1 week to submit the lab report. In the lab report, you have to include these compulsory and major things. Number one is introduction and theory. Number two is experimental procedure. Number three is result. Number four is discussion, conclusion, and last but not least, and the one of the most important thing is good number of references, ample amount of references in your report. Your report should not be something which is copy-paste, okay? The Turnitin threshold for you is 20%. If your similarity index is more than 20%, then perhaps you might be given 0 marks for your report. So when we talk about report rubrics, these are the rubrics as well: introduction, methodology or experimental details, results, discussion, conclusion, references, and originality. So this is something that we will evaluate for you guys. So this is your title page for your lab report number one. It is very, very important for you guys that you should basically mention the group number. So let's say you belong to section M01. So section M01 and group number, it is A, B, C or 1, 2, 3. I think it's, let's say F. So you should mention, don't forget to mention this section and group number. So here also you can see in the report, we will check these things. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think writing skills was not present in the rubric, so I will add writing skills also in the rubric. So what are the things that you should be careful about when making or writing a report? So before I give you the briefing, it is important that you should know what are the mistakes that people do when making a report. So here you can see that this page is not scanned properly. So it is important that please scan something properly, okay? And if you are typing something, then make sure that you type these things as well. If there is a separate drawing, then okay, perhaps you can make a separate drawing on a piece of paper. However, whatever needs to be written, it should be written on the Microsoft Word equation editor. Okay? So use equations or math tab or equation editor tab to put things in the lab report. That is something that we will see in your lab report. Number two, here you can see that the data is not plotted correctly. Okay, and this is a nice graph, so everything looks correct. But once again, there is a mistake here. There is no label of x-axis. There is no label for y-axis. There is no unit. Okay, on x-axis, there is no unit on y-axis. So make sure that you have performed these things very well. Make sure your graph is crisp and clear, CNC. Crisp and clear, okay? Make sure that the lines are very thin, okay? Make sure that the data is well presented. You should know at this time that how to make an Excel graph. If you don't know how to make an Excel graph, contact me. I will send you some good, or I will show you how to make a good graph from Excel. Next, reference and referencing style. It is important that you should follow referencing style. Okay? Let's say you have got square brackets. So you should put square brackets for references. Here you can see that the student put the just the book reference only, okay, and the website reference only. But where is this reference? What is the reference number? Reference number is not present. So you should put reference where from where you take the data. So let's say this is a square bracket, reference number one. And then reference number one is this. And then you should put the reference. Okay. The reference style should be APA or numbered or something which is consistent. Use consistent referencing and referencing style. If you want, you can use softwares like EndNote, Mendeley, but at least you should have, for a long report, you should have good number of reference. Maybe perhaps if you have 10 pages, then at least I expect 10 pages, 10 references. Okay, so you should have good amount of references, and they should be genuine references, not like copy paste any reference. No, from where you took that data, from wherever you copy paste something, you have to write it in your own words so that there is no similarity. And it is important that you should put the reference, the correct reference in the report. So I'm going to check references very, very clearly and carefully. I will check each and every reference that you're going to put in the report. So that is very important for you to secure. I think the difference between B and A will be references. Next, students miss units. Here you can see the unit is correctly written. However, it is meter 3 per second. What is meter 3 per second? It is not correct. It is meter cube per second. So you should have this, you should know that you should put references correctly, and in the table they should be in the brackets. Okay. Next, you can see in this report, you can see that one picture is very large, one picture is very small, one picture is in this area, one picture is in that area. So this is not a good example. It should be very well in the same areas. It should be properly put in the report. Number two, there are four labels, 1, 2, 3, and there are no labels for this one. Okay, so label is missing. Label is missing, and the label are, these are two labels separately. This is also wrong. You should put A, B, C, and D, and then we should put figure, then write something A is this, comma B is something like this, comma C is something like this, and D is this. If we have multiple figures, then you should know how to label multiple figures in the form of A, B, C, and D. So you have to put A and then B. brackets. So figure should be formatted correctly. Another example of mistake is efficiency. Here you can see the scale. The scale is starting from 206 and it is ending at 226, very random. And I cannot plot anything. You see, you have got two data points. So how will I plot? Like this, should I plot? Is it this direction, what is this? Here, what kind of plot is this? This is not a correct plot. So make sure that your scale is something, scale should be correct. Okay. Then flow rate unit should be written, unit is missing. Percentage efficiency is missing. Okay. And then this is very short label, make it a long label. So figure 1A, figure, let's say 1A, efficiency of a single plum, XYZ. Something like that. So make sure that you format the report correctly. That is very important. So don't copy paste anything. As I said earlier, copy pasting anything will result in 0 marks. The maximum limit for your similarity is 20%. So make sure that whatever you do, it is within the limit of 20%. If you want, turn it in ID, contact lecturer, and lecturer will give you turn it in ID for you to check your similarity. You can check your similarity, just ask the lecturer, turn it in ID, the class ID and password. So he or she will give you the class ID and password. So as I said earlier, your short reports are going to be your quiz. Okay. That is why you have to submit the quiz on the same day before 12 o'clock. Okay. Short report should have only 3 things: results, discussion, conclusion, and if there are any question and answers which are required, you need to fill that question and answers as well. So the practical will be evaluated by the GP, 20%, and he or she will inform you about how this assessment will be carried out. And for practical, you, as I said earlier, they will check your safety, your theory knowledge, your efficiency, how you do assembly, how do you do the tidiness, measurements, okay, and how you do troubleshooting. So I will give you a very short safety briefing for this lab. So in general, the safety guidelines are as follows, that you should follow all the safety procedures which are going to be indicated by the GP or which are written on the lab modules or which are indicated in the laboratory itself if you are going to see the laboratory. There are some first aid measures also, and there is an emergency response team available in UMP for you. You should always avoid direct skin contact, and you should always wear rubber gloves if you are using chemicals or something like that, or if you are dealing with some sharp specimen. You should also protect your eyes very carefully during the time. There is something called personal protective equipment or PPE. The use of PPE is important for you guys. You should use safety goggles so that anything cannot come through your eyes when there is some experiment going on. You should always, if there is a need, then you should use face shield as well. Lab coat is important for you guys to use, and safety hand glove can be used if you are using any chemical. Chemical might not be used for this lab perhaps, so I will not go through this chemical based PPE. However, you should always be cautious and take precautions. So these are some of the safety guidelines which have been given to you on Kalam. So please go through them and read them, and there might be some variation for you from safety as well later on during the sessions with JP. So this was all about the safety. So this is all about today's lab. I hope you guys understood how this lab is going to be carried out. I hope today everybody has marked their attendance, and in the next lab session also they will be marking their labs. There will not be any session for week number 3, so the labs will be starting from week number 3. The data, the lab sheet, the video, everything will be given to you guys by the lecturer, and the JT will also be well informed and will be present. So thank you guys, and if you have any question, I am open for that question and answer session.